Remove the outer door and... I don't know what to make of this. I know this is connected to that thing in the cave. The entity. After all the time I've been here. The things I've seen. I tried to keep Amy's research work going on here. Even with the lack of light, the plants seem to be doing fine. But the bees are behaving strangely. They seem to spread some kind of luminescent dust. Now they are keeping out of reach, so I haven't been able to catch one to examine, but I'll keep trying. This is some kind of experiment. I wouldn't mind it ending soon and the rescue team coming through the airlock. Feels like a month when you're alone in the dark. This is Karen Kowalski. I am a technician here in Research Base M. I don't know how, but it looks like everyone has disappeared. I was building the platform below the lab and then... Well, most of the power is off. Communications are out. And the airlock door is stuck. At least the oxygen level seems stable. So if you're listening to this, come and find me. I found our doctor's lighter in the study. Along with the limited power I've been able to generate from the exercise bike and... Well, let there be light, as they say. I brought up some fertilizer from the cargo, but that hasn't really perked up the plants at all. I guess I'm not the only one missing sunlight around here. I tried to keep Amy's research work going on here. Even with the lack of light, the plants seem to be doing fine. But the bees are behaving strangely. They seem to spread some kind of luminescent dust. Now, they are keeping out of reach, so I haven't been able to catch one to examine, but I'll keep trying. If this is some kind of experiment, I wouldn't mind it ending soon and the rescue team coming through the airlock. A week feels like a month when you're alone in the dark. Oh, fuck it. I'm holding on to whatever keeps me even close to sane. Yeah, Karen. Don't give it up just yet. I'm so tired of hoping for any goddamn thing anymore. I'm tired of this loop. I'm tired of calling it life. Oh, it's getting quite stifling in here. I'm thinking about moving into the lab and stop avoiding the thing in there. The atmosphere there feels somehow lighter. Yeah, it's Karen. Nothing in the base changes. My hair and fingernails were not growing. I think time was standing still. I dream about Ethan and Jessica every night. Even the drugs don't numb the dreams anymore. Yet I keep taking them. In some of the dreams, I'm back at home. But I act like I'm dead. Not hearing anything I say and just looking right through me. I keep telling myself they're only nightmares. I'm alive. I know I'm alive. Patrick is dead. But I am alive. I want him to have a face again. I began recording these messages for the researchers, but I guess I'm doing this for myself now. I only found a couple of cassettes, so I had to tape over the old ones. I think this one is going through its 6th re-recording already. The boredom's really been getting to me. Out of desperation, I've decided to break into the study library. I had to manually override the door system. You know, things are getting bad when you're resorting to breaking and entering just to read some of Philip's literary classics. By the time I get out of here, I'll probably be the most sophisticated Rama technician in the solar system. Peeking inside people's private quarters is revealing, to say the least. To Paul's quarters, not surprisingly, reflects how into their research they are. Amy, on the other hand, seems to have a soft spot for romance and nurturing. Marcia's room was the dump I expected it to be. Aside from moonlighting as a space burglar, I've mostly been reading books, popping sleeping pills, and reflecting on my life. The life I had before ending up in this limbo. I just read that without external circumstances, human date length can vary between 18 and 52 hours. Human date length can vary between 18 and 52 hours. So I can't rely on my sleeping rhythm when estimating time. It's probably around mid-April. And time for yet another diary entry from yours truly. I've managed to break into every room in the station in search of anything worth salvaging. Mainly I've been looking for some entertainment and ways to record this diary. Lan's music cassettes have been the most handy for that task, and frankly, I feel he owed them to me. The thing in the lab gives me the creeps. It makes me feel so warm and soothing, but my rational mind refuses to comprehend it. I try to visit the lab as little as possible because something just